Hello everybody, boys and girls, combines and aliens, and Half-Life fans. My name is Polis Ranger, and today we are gonna do a Half-Life 2 Gman Theory. Now, it's pretty interesting how this theory would go, but we are gonna talk about mostly G-Man, and nothing but G-Man. So at first, let's continue. But before I start, have a look at the video here and here. This is a pretty interesting phrase what other people have done. This one's from the Sticky Paddle YouTube channel, so go and check him out. It's pretty interesting of that theory and whatever's up here. So, without further ado, let's get on with the theory. Now, who is G-Man? Who does he work for? Why does he wear that suit? What's in his suitcase? And what's with him saying certain words and syllables? Well, first we need to know where is he came from, and maybe who is he working for. Now, in the first game, we've seen him going around, you know, looking around, keeping an eye on you, and nothing but you. And there have been G-Man spots, which I guess is one of the videos I'll leave up, is G-Man spottings. So, yeah. But it is pretty interesting how he just walks calmly around. But yet again, what could he be? What is he? In the second game, you see him more, and same for episode 1 and episode 2. In episode 1, he basically tells you that you're somewhere safe, and you had to take your weapons because they were government properties. And he's interested in your services for his employers. And yet again, you're in this train car with an endless tunnel, I guess, or cyberspace, or whatever it is. And G-Man gives you two options. You go through the green portal, and you basically sign the contract of doing what G-Man requests of you, or die a horrible, painful death. And basically, we choose the first one. Signing our life away. In the second one, G-Man summons you in the game. And this time, you wake up in the train. Just like in the first one. In the train. Pretty interesting, isn't it? Now, G-Man tells you to wake up and smell the ashes in a very creepy way. And saying the pilot, you've been sleeping on the job. Well, we have been in stasis after all. But how the hell did we manage to survive from Black Mesa to Zen to suddenly back into Europe? Were we in the United States, but we're more in Mexico? Pretty interesting, isn't it? But yet again, through the game, you see G-Man, and then suddenly at the end of the second game, G-Man basically says, "Time, Dr. Freeman, is he really there? Time again." Basically, how much damage we have caused as Gordon Freeman, G-Man has been so impressed that his so-called employers are impressed of him. And we have to be at stasis, and he has to go for his next stop. Which is quite interesting. But the question is really, who is he? Now, after playing Half-Life 2 and playing the first one, my guess that G-Man could be some kind of being, an alien being. Now, he can't be God. That would be a bit outrageous. But yet again, we don't know. But G-Man has some kind of thing, you know. He speaks certain syllables, he's a calm man, and he knows what he's doing. And he's interested in Gordon. But who's his employers? It can't be the Combines. If it was the Combines, surely he would have stopped us by now. I think G-Man's working for someone else, another alien race that we don't know yet. Or he's working for an organization that nobody knows. Luminati confirmed. Nah, not really. Let's just cut their shit out, really. Yeah. But yet again, we don't know exactly. Now, the thing is, He could be a god or a representative of God. Or he could be another alien being that we never faced before. He's been everywhere, Black Mesa. Was he the cause of the resonance cascade? Or was he not? It's clever scripted. And here's the thing. You know what? Valve only give us a tiny bit of information on G-Man. Just a tiny spoonful of G-Man. And then we just have to wait until episode 3. Or Half-Life 3. Shocking, isn't it? So, that's the fact. We only get a little bit of information and that's it. I think it's episode 2 that Alex Vance's father tells us. Which is quite interesting. Like, he knew about G-Man and who G-Man was. Suspicious, isn't it? Now, the important thing is that if G-Man can, like, put things in Alex's words, like saying, prepare for unseen consequences, then G-Man knows something. Because the Combine Overwatch has been watching Gordon and all that. How did they know about Gordon? Did they capture the G-Man once? Or is there something involved with the G-Man in the Overwatch? Interesting, isn't it? It's like... very strange. Strange indeed. But again, we don't know exactly. Now, I don't know why G-Man says, prepare for unseen consequences. Now, to this rate, to actions have consequences. So, the actions of Gordon did, the consequences for him is someone dies. And that's very scary. But yet again, we don't know exactly why. Because he's a very strange man. He looks more or less human to me, except for his eyes. They look very alien-like. So really, we don't know who he could be. If you don't know what he looks like, here it is now. Pretty interesting, isn't it? It should be a picture with from the first one and the second one. Now, his haircut is strange, his voice, his suit. I don't know who he could be. But yet again, I'm quite interested about episode 3. Now, I am going to say some things about episode 3. First and all, though, it's been 10 years since the first one. How long did it take to make the first one? Well, how long did it take to Half-Life 2 made? I think it was 7 years or 10. I don't know exactly, but I will leave it up somewhere saying how many years it's been. So, because the first one was delayed so many times until it was done correctly, and the second one had to be delayed, so really, we could see about 15 years, or maybe until SteamOS has been released. Don't forget, Valve done it exactly right for the second and first one, and the two episodes. So in Gabe North's point of view, everything has to be done correctly. So by now, they're probably finished with the whole game and just need to get ready for the dialogue, editing, and the SFM trailer. So, yeah. And don't forget, though, Half-Life 3 Ball Mass more or less will be working on the Source engine, and then once the second one's done, convert to the Source 2 engine, do some minor tweaking and editing, and once it's done, then they'll announce it. There will be people making jokes saying Half-Life 3 confirmed and all this crap. Guys, if you want really the truth of Half-Life 3 being confirmed, wait until Valve says so. Because really, people will just say anything. They'll just even put a video saying Half-Life 3 confirmed, and really it isn't. If you want to know when it's actually confirmed, wait until Valve announces it. Because the only people... and the only truth you can get of that Half-Life franchise is Valve themselves. So just wait patiently, We don't know what could come out next year. Just have to be very patient. And once it's been finished, that will tell us. So, we'll just really just enjoy the game as it is. But anyway, thank you for having much. I know it's not really much of a theory video, but yet again, I don't know who G-Man is. So anyway, share the video, like it, subscribe to become a ranger today. If you want to put your own theories about the G-Man on this video, I'm happy for you to oblige, because the comments are free for any theories. So put down your theories, and you know what, I'm looking forward to it. So thank you very much, everybody, and I'll see you sooner or later, really. I don't know exactly. And what next theories do you want me to do? Leave in the comments. Goodbye, and have a good day, Dr. Freeman.
Time, Dr. Freeman? Is it really that time again? It seems as if you only just arrived. You've done a great deal in a small time span. You've done so well, in fact, that I've received some interesting offers for your services. Ordinarily, I wouldn't contemplate them, but these are extraordinary times. Rather than offer you the illusion of free choice, I will take the liberty of choosing for you. If and when your time comes round again. I do apologize for what must seem to you an arbitrary imposition, Dr. Freeman. I trust it will all make sense to you in the course of... Well, I'm really not at liberty to say. In the meantime, this is where I get off.
Lamar? Lamar!
Blast that little... Where did she get to?